I'm currently in a bad reading slump. I've never been in a reading slump, but I didn't really know the term until I started watching BookTube. I recently filmed my mid-year freak attack, but I just haven't had much luck this year with reading. There's obviously been some great books I've read and some books that, you know, they were great, but I still haven't found any books that have left me speechless. Like, for example, last year around this time, I had already found so many new favorite books, so many books that are still in my mind. But so far this year, I haven't read any books that, you know, books that I think about 24/7. So that sucks. So I was watching some BookTube videos about people getting out of reading slumps, and there was this trend of people saying this video ends whenever I found a new 5-star read, and I decided to do that. But instead of just choosing many, many books that I think are going to be a 5-star, I just chose one book that I don't know if it will be a 5-star, but I know I will have a great reading time reading it. And that book is Frankenstein by Mary Shelley. If you've been watching my videos for a while, you will know why I think I will adore this book. So I read Romantic Outlaws by Charlotte Gordon last year. It was such an amazing read. It's a biography about Mary Shelley and Mary Wollstonecraft. The Romanticism period is one of my favorite periods. There's a lot of paintings in my bedroom of that romantic period. I left my dog alone in my living room and now she's coming with me. Lo siento, mi amor. No te quería dejar sola. Venga, pasa. I feel so bad that I left her alone. Frankenstein was actually written during summer. It took some time to actually finish the novel, but the idea and the majority of the book was written during a dark summery storm. And today apparently it's going to rain. We're going to have a thunderstorm. I thought it was a perfect time to start reading this book. A little historical background of when Frankenstein was written. Like I said, this book was written during a summer, but it was written during a very dark summer because there was a volcano eruption in Indonesia, and that volcano eruption was so brutal that it changed the entire world's temperature for 3 years. There was a lot of famine, they didn't have summers for 3 years, and it was a very dark period of time. Apparently it's the most brutal volcano eruption recorded to date. So you can just imagine a 19-year-old Mary Shelley in Switzerland in a very dark night where she has to come up with a ghost story. The result of that is Frankenstein, and I think the name is inspired by the Frankenstein castle in Germany, I believe. There's just so much historical context behind this book, and I cannot wait to do a lot of research, because if you know something about me, I love doing research with books that I really adore. I just go into this whole tantrum where I just get so obsessed with the subject. When I read Dracula, I was obsessed with it. I started searching on Google Maps all the references that Bram Stoker was writing. There's actually a really cool book, which is Dracula by Dacre Stoker, which is his great grandnephew, I believe. And he compiled all the information that Bram Stoker wrote about Dracula, because apparently Bram Stoker actually believed in vampires, which is just, it's so fun to read about because he wrote Dracula. Vampires is something that, like, I don't believe in vampires. Biologically, it doesn't make any sense. It's just so cool to think about, like, vampires as a concept. If you could be any mythological creature, what would you be? I don't think I would be a vampire. Like, with vampirism lore, you have the Vampire Diaries, where you can compulse people to do the things you want to do, and all the vampires that I've seen are rich, which, you know, it's something very cool. But at the same time, not being able to go in the sun, like, I know it changes between vampire lore, but overall I don't think I would be a vampire. I wouldn't be a werewolf, because that would be very stressful for me. I would love to be a witch. Like, I would love to be able to do magic. I don't know why I started talking about that. But anyways, I'm going to start reading Frankenstein. And hopefully I'm going to have a grand time reading it, because I need some of that. I've never really had, like, a terrible reading slump. These past few weeks, I've had such bad luck with reading. I tend to DNF books that I don't like, so I don't usually have, like, terrible reads. But these past few weeks, I've picked up, like, I think 20 books. Like, I've picked up so many books on my Kindle, and I just haven't been able to finish any of them, because I don't know, I just haven't been captivated by them. And then the ones that I have finished, they weren't that good. I read The Wager. I finally read The Wager, which was one, I I think it was like my most anticipated release of this year. I gave it 2 stars. I didn't like it. The way that book was written, it gave me a whiplash. Like the way it was written, like the timeline, I couldn't do it. I finished the book because I was interested in the story. But once I finished the book, I actually had to search online the story because I was so confused and I feel like I read the entire book and I still didn't know the story. It doesn't make sense, but yeah, it was a bad book, and I think the fact that my most anticipated release was such a big fail kind of tainted my reading experience. And then I read some thrillers that also, with thrillers, is always a hit or miss. And I actually read a graphic novel, Fangs, which was a really fun read. Okay, let's get to reading.
It's currently thunderstorming a lot. It's actually really nice.
I passed the summer of 1816 in the environs of Geneva. The season was cold and rainy, and in the evenings we crowded around a blazing wood fire and occasionally amused ourselves with some German stories of ghosts, which happened to fall into our hands. These tales excited in us a playful desire of imitation.
I just read a few pages of the book from what I've read so far. I'm really liking it. I'm going to make some food right now because I need to eat something. I've actually found a really interesting video about Frankenstein, like everything you need to know about Frankenstein, and I'm going to watch it while I eat. I want to know as much as I can about the historical context of the book and just anything that tells us more about the story. The title of the video is Everything You Need to Know to Read Frankenstein.
Mount Tambora plunged parts of...
I decided I'm going to create a new tab. I think I'm going to use this pink one because it's very different from the other colors, to do a tab for the weather descriptions. When I read Dracula, I wish I had tabbed the weather descriptions. I did tab the weather, but I just didn't make it its own tab. I love talking about the weather. I know a lot of people say that people that talk about the weather, or talking about the weather, is for people that are not interested, or for people that don't have anything to talk about. I love talking about the weather. If it's raining where you live, please describe the atmosphere, please describe the color of the sky, please describe the sound the rain is making. Not only with rain, also with snow, with sunshine. I just love nature, and the weather with nature is a part of it. They're currently describing a very icy atmosphere, and it's only the 31st of July. They're going to the Northern Pole, so it's very cold, obviously. And also, this was written during a year where there wasn't a summer, so it's just... these are things I'm very interested in. I don't care if people say it's boring. I love reading about the weather.
You can see her paw right there.
Oh, who's here? Last night I started watching this video, which is 18 terrifying TikToks that can't be explained, and I couldn't continue watching it because I was, you know, scared. So I thought, let's watch it during the morning because I won't be scared. I just saw a fucking video that is not going to let me sleep tonight. Thank God I have Betty with me. This is a video. I'm going to link it down below in case you want to watch it, right? It's scary. Just saying. Do you believe in the supernatural? Because if you do, you're going to be scared. I'm currently on chapter 7 on page 68 of Frankenstein. I don't know if it's Frankenstein or Frankenstein. I keep saying Frankenstein, but I feel like it's Frankenstein. I don't know. I did know the story of this book. I knew what was going to happen. I just didn't know the timelines and the pacing of the story. I didn't know that the monster, the creature, was going to be created so early in the book. I don't know why I thought it was going to be around the ending. There's a lot of things that I just didn't know were going to happen. I guess I just knew the story of Frankenstein, but I just didn't know, you know, the actual book story. I've also never seen any movie adaptation. I feel like it's just the cultural references that you get everywhere where you just know the story without actually knowing the story. I know there's a movie with Elle Fanning and Douglas Booth. I'll think of May Shelley's Life. I want to watch the movie because I think in that movie you see her in Geneva
writing Frankenstein. The writing style so far is nothing spectacular, like it's not blowing my mind away. But that being said, there's a lot of beautiful prose and some beautiful passages. So far from my annotation, I have 4 different tabs. The blue is for fate passages, the gray is for history, the pink is for weather, and then I added a green one for science and nature. For the science and nature ones, I'm also tagging the whole the creation of the creature and how Frankenstein is just getting inspiration from scientists of his time and older scientists. A lot of science talk in this book, and there's a lot of scientists being mentioned, and it's always so fascinating because science can become obsolete so fast. Science is always evolving, and some scientists may think they have found the solution to everything, and then a few years after, another scientist will debunk their theory and another theory will be created. So I can understand that can be very frustrating.
¿Todo bien?
So apparently Taylor Swift has announced the European tour. I still haven't seen them. Hopefully she's coming to Spain. Maybe she will go to Madrid. And also I want to see who's coming with her. Let's see the dates and also who's coming with her. Okay, let's see. Sabrina Carpenter. Wait. Okay, just coming to Madrid. Okay, that's fine. That's great. Okay, now let's buy the tickets.
I've been in this queue for the past 30 minutes. It's moving a little bit, but this is everything I've done in 30 minutes. We have all of this left. Wish me luck.
It's my last penguin. I'm so sad.
Good morning.
During summer, I always wake up very early so I can take baby for a walk before it gets too hot. That means I don't sleep a lot. But for baby, I would do anything. I'm currently rewatching season 1 of The Summer That I Turned Pretty before season 2 comes out. Honestly, I adore this TV show so much. It's just the sweetest thing. They have changed a lot of things from the books to the TV adaptation. So hopefully they will also change Jeremiah's storyline, because if they follow the same ones that are in the books, they're going to ruin this series and I'm not going to like it. Today is midsummer here in Spain. It's a big night here in Spain. There's a lot of celebrations and there's a lot of parties as well. But I'm staying home with Betty. She recently had surgery. Her scar got infected very sadly. So I'm extremely anxious about that. I don't want to think about it because it makes me really sad. She's currently under my bed, hiding from the firework. My plan for tonight is to eat sushi while I watch a scary movie. I ordered a lot of sushi. I'm going to show you everything that I ordered for tonight. These are some veggie gyozas, some chicken yakisoba, some baos, chicken baos. Then this is a dessert actually. This is cheesecake Nutella and the bottom is Oreos. Then some sushi rolls, more sushi rolls, and more sushi rolls. You may think that's a lot of food for one person. Don't underestimate me. I can eat all of this. I'm going to put that dessert on the fridge. I'm in the biggest food coma right now, but everything is so good.
Weather, however, suddenly became serene, and my two friends left me on a journey among the Alps, and lost in the magnificent scenes which they present.
I just took a shower. I'm going to do my skincare routine and then I'm going to continue reading Frankenstein. I'm on chapter 7 of volume 3. I'm almost done with the book actually. I think I only have one chapter left, and then after that I have The Nightmare of Romantic Idealism by Paul Cantor. I think this is just a commentary of the romantic period. I love that Penguin always does amazing introductions and those amazing commentaries, usually for the time period or maybe the literary movement, the genre. They usually do really good introductions. The Penguin Black editions always have amazing introductions. This one didn't have an introduction. Maybe these editions do not have introductions. I read the famous quote of "Beware, for I am fearless and therefore powerful." It's such a powerful quote. It's just an amazing way to say, since I am fearless, I'm also powerful because I don't have anything to lose. I'm not scared of anything, so that makes me powerful. It's quite amazing if you think about that. Also, I didn't realize how sad the story actually was. Like I said, I knew the story, but I didn't know the complete story. And everyone says that Frankenstein is not the monster. But he kind of is. Like, Dr. Frankenstein, I don't like him, and I feel so bad for the creature because all he wants is just someone to love him and someone to be with, and no one accepts him. So that's very sad. Honestly, this book is kind of sad, not gonna lie.
Good morning. Last night we had a beautiful thunderstorm here. I went to bed very, very late, and now I'm very, very tired. The new Olivia Rodrigo song came out. She hasn't released new music in like 2 years, I think. I'm going to be listening and reacting to the new song with you. It's called Vampire. Some people think that it's like a reference to Twilight. Oh, it's the first thing on my YouTube. Okay, it's 4 minutes. She's pretty. She looks so pretty. She sounds very different, right? Like, I feel like she sounds different. What? What the fuck? I woke up Betty. I'm so sorry. I like this song. I do. She looks so pretty in this music video as well. Is she flying? I don't know how they filmed this, but it looks really cool. Okay.
Last night I finished reading Frankenstein by Mary Shelley, and I stand correct. This book is extremely sad. The ending was extremely sad. I knew it wasn't going to be a happy book per se. I'm still reading the essay on the back. It's really, really interesting. The author, Paul Cantor, talks about the romantic genre and how romanticism has influenced this book, as well as how this book has influenced several books a posteriori. I'm still digesting this book and my thoughts on it, but my overall thoughts right now is that I really liked it. I'm very thankful that I finally found a book that I really liked, because I haven't had much luck, like I said. The entire talk about death and life and being able to resuscitate the dead was such an interesting topic, especially since Mary Shelley had always had trouble with her mother's death, because her mother died giving birth to Mary Shelley, and she always felt very connected to her mother, even though she didn't know her mother. Like I said, this book is from the romantic period, and the romantic period really focuses on emotions, which this book really does, and also the juxtaposition between the beautiful and the grotesque, which also this obviously does. But also something that romantic literature always focuses on is nature, like the profound connection with nature. And I feel like this didn't really do that. My green tab is actually for science and nature, but I just didn't found that many profound connections with nature. Like, the descriptions weren't that immersive, and I felt like, yes, this is a romantic piece of literature, but it didn't have every single romantic element, which obviously not every single novel has that. I'm really happy that I finally read this book, because I feel like it's going to stay with me for a while, and I do want to reread it, because I think that second time that I read it with my annotations and everything, I will have a more in-depth, profound connection with this book. I hope you guys liked this video, and I will see you very, very soon. Bye!